Hey guys, this is Ali, and welcome to another review for a product for Cinema 4D. And this time it's gonna be a GP light kit or studio tools for V-Ray. And I uploaded a video letting you guys that you can go and buy it if you want. But now I'll show you a couple of renders and what do you get when you buy it. So let's jump to the content browser and let's look for our V-Ray light kit, which is there we go, V-Ray Studio Tools. And you know, like any light kit, it's definitely not like grayscale done light kit. This is specially made for V-Ray render engine. If you don't know what V-Ray, then I don't know why the heck you're watching this video, but yeah, something new to learn. Alright, so you get basically a couple of soft boxes and reflection kind of soft boxes, and also you get V-Ray camera for movies already set up, because everything is completely different from Cinema 4D. Anything that you're gonna use in Cinema 4D, lights, camera, floor, object, some of object need to have a tag, which is you need to go over here and sign a tag to it. So basically it's completely headache. That's what V-Ray, I swear to God, I tried so many times to understand this render engine and come up with crazy tutorials for it, but no, it's like in your face, you're not gonna learn how do anything over here. But yeah, it takes some time I guess to learn stuff. But yeah, let's go back to this light kit or studio tools. And first folder you get extra, which is just V-Ray physical sky, day and night, and you get water drop, just experimental I guess project if you want to have fun with it. And also you have the studio what you call a studio object, which is you get a box and basically look stuff that you're gonna use to render or do a test render I guess. And you get a couple of studios also, you can use them. And you get my favorite part now, the studio preset. Basically what these are render setting. Basically you just double click on it and it will do the whole render setting for you. Easy as that. And for the sake of this tutorial, I'm gonna stick to low render setting, so excuse me, this is just gonna take forever to render while I'm recording, and rendering with V-Ray it's just gonna take forever, so I'll stick with the low render setting. So this is where studio object. Now we have studio preset, now we have the studio setup, which is the next one. You get a couple of studios ready with the soft boxes, everything ready. So you basically just drag to your object manager and you're good to go. So let's start with the color, two color studio, bam, in your face. And the good thing, it takes just a second to load all the materials and texture for you. And you see, it comes with a camera and plus an object to do your test render or whatever. So let's go to the camera and bam, in your face, here we go. And like I said, we have our render setting set to low, so we're good to go. So just click render. And it looks like it's rendering really fast, but we just want to go to the object, it just takes a little bit of time. Also in the final render, I think I want to, one frame it took about 35 seconds, which is not bad for V-Ray. Not bad at all. 35 seconds for one frame, not bad at all for V-Ray. I had some project took about a minute to render, and it's not V-Ray even, it's just Cinema 4D. So you compare this to V-Ray, it's crazy. Even when low, by the way, even when using the low render setting, you still get these beautiful renders. As you can see here, look at that. Really beautiful, really natural lighting, and it's just amazing. Looks really amazing. Definitely worth getting this light kit if you just starting using V-Ray. So basically you don't have to worry about lighting, and the most important thing about V-Ray, trust me when I say it, lighting. If you can't get the right render setting, then it will never work. And also the light, the softboxes also have the setting, so you can go and play with these setting. You have color preset, couple of presets over here. Also all these settings, you know, I'm not gonna go each one of these settings. Basically you can see, you can change the size, the shadow, light option, and mask, which is you can turn it off, seen by camera, not seen by camera, this kind of stuff, and visible in the editor, not visible in the editor, all of these goodies. Same thing goes for all the soft boxes. And so this is, as you saw, this two color render. Let's use another studio actually, and just gonna delete all of these, and I'm leaving this object for later so you can see how it looks like using textures. Let's grab three light studio, and let's go inside the camera, and here we go, and let's do a render for this one. Some of these studios take a bit of time to render, not that much. It doesn't go over a minute. I'm pretty sure if you're using low render setting, it doesn't go over a minute. Sometimes it does. It depends on your material setting. But look at this. So freaking amazing. I just love the render. It just looks so natural. Alright, so I guess this is gonna take a minute. Thank you for proving me wrong, V-Ray. But yeah, still we got a couple of seconds. But put you in mind, even if this takes some time over here on the final render, definitely double the time of the final render. So it's gonna take a minute over here, then end of the final render will take about 2 minutes or a minute and a half. So exactly 1 minute, that's just insane, exactly 1 minute. So yeah, this is how the setup for three lights. Look at how awesome this render. And let's go and choose another studio. We're gonna choose two more studios, and then I'll leave it up to you. When you buy it, you can, you know, see your renders. Also, you get also a HDRI studio setup, which is pretty cool. You can drag your HDRI images. Let's select, say for example, this one. This one will do. And let's go inside the camera and let's render this. I think this is the one that takes a bit time. Not really sure. Yeah, this is the one. Last time took with me quite time to render it. I don't know why, but it's just, and it was set to medium quality. The quality was set to medium. Took me about, I think, 3 minutes and a half or something to render just one frame. And I was like, heck no, let me cancel the render. Also, happy Eid, everyone, if you celebrating Eid, which is, I don't know, someone asked me, I think, before, he's like, what is Eid? What do you do in Eid? It's like Halloween? Nope, it's not like Halloween. First of all, we don't wear costumes and stuff like that. We just wear regular clothes, I guess. And we don't give candy, basically. We give money. You know, like, you guys give candy, you know, like, trick-or-treat, I think, or something. Trick-or-treat, whatever. But we don't do this. We just give money, you know. Because, you know, we do it like a boss. But seriously, no, I'm not joking. We give money, you know. No, I'm just messing. No, but really, I'm not even joking over here. But yeah, this is the render, you saw it. And the final render, which is, I'm going to use this object, the cube that I have over here, which is just regular cube, as you can see here now. It's just a cube and nothing special. You can see it's set to GI mode, I guess. Alright, let's add the, let's use the dark reflection. No, we don't want the reflection. Let's use this one. And bam, I'm just gonna delete the spheres. We don't need them. And we good to go, I think. Yep, we good to go. Alright, let me just set up this, right? Let's take the cube and move it to the front. Somewhere about here will be fine. Yep, that'll be good. Which is just a normal cube. I did some modeling on it, extrude out and all this stuff, and added the texture to it. But this is how it's gonna look like when you use V-Ray with it. I swear to God, if you see the render and Cinema 4D and this render over here, it looks completely different. And let's go actually get a close shot. That'll be interesting. Over here. Now that's gonna take some time to render, so you know, be patient. Yep, so this is how it's gonna look like. If you want a link for this cube, because I know someone gonna ask, how did you make the cube? Well, if you want a link for it, just let me know in the comment, and I'll upload it and post it in Facebook, or post the link in description or something. So this is a close shot of the cube. That was like was gonna be a speed art, but I didn't record it, so I was like, I'm not redoing this again. That took me a lot of time to recreate. But yeah, so this is some of the stuff that you get with the studio tools for V-Ray. This is just some of the stuff. There's a lot of stuff over here. This one is pretty interesting, so if you guys want to watch this one, it's going to look awesome. Let me just go on the camera. And let's do a render. This is set for depth of field kind of look. And you get pretty interesting result for depth of field. Really soft kind of depth of field. Not the one you get with Cinema 4D. It's so freaking blurry as hell. You don't know if you're seeing a circle or you're seeing freaking particles. You know? But yeah. And you can see it render pretty fast also. And some of these have a lot of reflection. Some of these objects or veins, I don't know what you call them. And another thing, I got Modern Warfare 3 yesterday for Xbox. No one had it for Xbox yet. Well, as far as I know, in my country. And let me tell you guys, the game is really awesome. Really amazing. You're gonna love it. I was gonna upload some videos to the channel, you know, just showing, you know, get the game first in your face, you know, but I was like, nah, I don't wanna get copyrighted or something. So yeah, this is with the depth of field, as you can see here, a bit of blurry in the back and focused on over here. Pretty awesome renders you get. So this is the light kit, and also I'm doing a giveaway for two licenses, by the way. I'm gonna ask a question, and I will leave a comment, a question, and all you have to do is just reply with the answer for this question or my comment, and you'll be good to go. I'm not gonna say what's the question. You have to read it and you have to reply to it. That's all of it. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and hope you like this I think a simple review or basic review of what you can do with this light kit. You seeing how long render time it takes the render time. V-Ray is not a joke. It's not a global illumination. It's not ambient occlusion. It's higher. Okay, I made it sound like some god or something. Alright, anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Peace. And I have to click this.